Josh Taylor has conquered the 140-pound division, becoming the first Scottish undisputed light welterweight king on Saturday, May the 22nd, 2021. The win was nothing short of impressive as the Tartan Tornado became undisputed in just 18 professional fights. However, most people glance over the fact of how historical Josh's achievement of winning the undisputed crown truly is when you consider the factors we're about to delve into. So it's great to have you here at Ringside Stories. I'm your host, Boxing's Objective Observer. And before we start, I want to thank you for watching in advance, and I think you'll absolutely love this video. So please consider a like, consider a share, subscribe, and hit that notification bell because it will help grow the channel, thus inspire me to make more of this kind of content. Now, disclaimer, in this video, we're considering undisputed boxing champions with at least two major belts. Disclaimer two, I know Josh Taylor is a proud Scotsman, and I mean no disrespect at all. However, for this video, we'll consider Josh Taylor British. You might ask why? Well, simply for the purpose of underlining how historical Josh Taylor's conquest of the 140-pound division on May 22nd, 2021 truly was. Not just going by the eye test, but also considering historical data with facts, fairness, and proper context. Let's get into it. On the surface, it looked like another match against another top-level fighter who, oh, by the way, was undefeated in 26 professional fights, held two of the major world titles with a respectable following, who, given the fact the fight was held in his home country of the USA, was considered to be competitive in this match, despite the fact Josh Taylor made him fight his fight for most part, despite the fact Josh Taylor scored two legitimate knockdowns with a very, very long count after the second knockdown. Make of that what you want. Fortunately, the right man won on the night, and boxing fans were spared of what could have been one of boxing's many robberies. Josh Taylor is the first British fighter to become undisputed champion in the modern four-belt era. More on that later. Now, looking closer into all undisputed boxing champions Great Britain has ever produced, Josh Taylor shares his spot with a select group of four. Lennox Lewis, who was the undisputed heavyweight world champion from November 13, 1999 until the 29th of April 2000, and, as of the making of this video, the last undisputed heavyweight world champion. Lloyd Honegan, who was the undisputed welterweight champion from September 27, 1986 until September 27 of 1987. Alan Minter, the undisputed middleweight world champion from March 16 to September 27 in 1980. And undisputed lightweight champion, Scotland's own Ken Buchanan, with newly crowned undisputed light welterweight champion Josh Taylor making his mark in boxing on May the 22nd, 2021, 50 years after his mentor Ken Buchanan, making for a full circle kind of story. However, there are three reasons why Taylor's achievement stands out from his selected competition. You'll understand Josh Taylor's achievement from a historical and legacy-defining point of view. Number one, shortest path to undisputed. Josh Taylor's first professional fight was on July 18th, 2015. The Tartan Tornado won undisputed on May 22nd of 2021, which amounts to a total of 2,135 days to become undisputed world champion. Still pretty fast, but not a novelty, since Josh's mentor Ken Buchanan, quote-unquote, only needed 1,971 days to achieve the same. However, the path to undisputed for Buchanan was longer, as it took him 40 fights. In fact, the only fellow Brit on this list that comes close to Josh Taylor's achievement is welterweight Lloyd Honegan with 28 fights. Still, Josh Taylor is the only Brit who managed to become undisputed world champion in just 18 professional fights. Number 2. Josh Taylor's road to undisputed. When looking at the quality of opposition, Josh Taylor's resume is solidified, mixing it with world-class, world championship-level fighters as early as his 11th fight. Josh fought former WBC light welterweight titleist Victor Postol who at the time only lost one points decision against future undisputed light welterweight champion Terence Crawford. After the postal fight, Josh went on to clean out the light welterweight division with a 962-day period from November 3rd, 2018 up until his fight for Undisputed on May 22nd, 2021, where the Tartan Tornado gave all of his five opponents their first loss. Two wins by stoppage, three wins against then reigning champions, IBF champion Ivan Baranchik, WBA champion Regis Progre, and unified WBO and WBC light welterweight champion Jose Ramirez. If you compare that body of work in a historical context, none of the British Undisputed champions faced the quality of opposition and route to Undisputed that Josh Taylor faced. You can only make a bit of a case for Lennox Lewis, who in his five fights leading up to his Undisputed title reign fought unified IBF and WBA heavyweight champion Evander Holyfield, which, though Lewis won convincingly in my opinion, ended in a draw officially. And Henry Akinwande, who was the former WBO world champion, although Akinwande vacated that belt in order to fight Lewis. Besides, at that time, the WBO belt was not recognized as one of the major world titles. So in this department, Josh Taylor takes the cake with ease. Not just by mere opposition, also the way he has performed in these fights. Josh Taylor can fight in a multiple of ways, both orthodox and southpaw, with the ability to switch up tactics in fight, which is proof of his overall boxing acumen. For example, in the Regis Progre fight, Josh was losing the battle at long range, so he decided to fight Progre toe-to-toe. Given Progre's 83% knockout ratio at the time, a high-risk strategy that eventually saw Josh Taylor winning a deserving majority decision. Regardless of Regis Progre's damage, that left Taylor with a humongous right eye. And remember, Regis Progre was the undefeated WBA light welterweight world champion, a very talented fighter who I believe will become world champion in the future once more. The other champions, Ivan Baranchik and Jose Ramirez, were both dropped in their fight with Josh Taylor, both losing by unanimous decision. As stated, Josh Taylor is the only British undisputed champion who faced multiple reigning champions before cementing his status as the main man in his division. Which leads us to number three, the modern day four belt era. Josh Taylor fights in an era where a fighter needs four major world titles to call himself undisputed world champion. And remember, this is an era where politics, i.e. money and reputation, pretty much navigate a fighter's career. An era where most fighters, for whatever reason, mostly only speak about but not fight for undisputed. Some of today's world champions are in a position of becoming undisputed champions, which include a potential future opponent for Josh Taylor and unified lightweight champion Teofimo Lopez, who bested Vasyl Lomachenko in 2020, adding two major titles to his collection. But since Devin Haney is the real WBC lightweight champion, Teofimo Lopez isn't undisputed just yet. Then at the 168-pound division, Saul Canelo Alvarez is hoping to become undisputed world champion somewhere in 2021. At heavyweight, Deontay Wilder spoke, believed, but has yet to receive. Same goes for Tyson Fury, even though unified heavyweight world champion Anthony Joshua sent multiple of career high offers to both Wilder and Fury in recent years. Yet as of today's video, we're still waiting for the first undisputed heavyweight world title fight since November of 1999, when Lennox Lewis took on real deal Evander Holyfield. And just to give some more context on how rare it is to become undisputed world champion in this modern day four belt era especially, Floyd Mayweather Jr. and Manny Pacquiao, who are widely regarded as boxing's two biggest superstars in the last 15 years, have never been undisputed champion. Something Josh Taylor has achieved, not by winning three or two in the case of old school champions, but four major world titles in just 18 professional fights. So there you have it. Three reasons why Josh Taylor's achievement, becoming undisputed world champion, is nothing less than impressive. What was not impressive was the exposure, or the lack thereof, his fight with Jose Ramirez got. The promotion was truly shocking. No UK broadcaster picked up the Taylor versus Ramirez fight, even though this was a historic fight for the undisputed world championship. To add insult to injury, Taylor's own promoter, Bob Arum, clearly wanted Jose Ramirez to win. Still, Josh Taylor went to his opponent's backyard, a unified, undefeated world champion, with his own promoter against him, with referee Kenny Bayless giving the hometown fighter some extra help, and three American judges scoring the fight. Although the Tartan Tornado did not finish his opponent, he left absolutely no doubt who the best 140-pound fighter was on Saturday, May 22nd, 2021. I believe we've witnessed a moment of boxing greatness that us boxing fans should applaud. And it's also a moment to remind other fighters to pursue greatness inside that squared circle. What do you make of Josh Taylor becoming undisputed light welterweight world champion? I'm very curious to read about your thoughts in the comments section. Feel free to like and share. Don't forget to subscribe to the channel and hit that notification bell. If you've done that already, thank you so much for your support. You are the real undisputed champion. This is Boxing Subjective Observer with Ringside Stories. Back with more later, but for now, thanks for watching and have a legendary day.